Hey, what is good, everyone? I am Koro. Welcome to another video. Today, we're talking about yet another death in the horror community. And I mean, at this point, it's no surprise. But I was actually kind of excited for this project. I hadn't talked about it before on YouTube, but I've known of this for a long time because a creator in the F13 community, quite a bit back in the good old days, you know, he actually is behind this project and one of the big, I guess, developers behind the game, and that is Paul Phoenix. So the game's title is called Killer, and there'll just be some footage on the screen of that. But pretty much, a lot of the, you know, it was looking really good for this game. They even almost had, well, they did have Kane Hodder that was going to do mocap for them, similar to Friday the 13th, the game. But due to the legal issues with Friday the 13th and their lawsuit, they actually were not allowed, which completely sucks. But yeah, so they've actually gotten a lot of stuff professionally done, really high quality work, and the game was, you know, shaping up pretty fast. But just recently, their Twitter has gone offline. You cannot follow it or find it anymore, which is a little odd. Paul Phoenix still has his up, so I mean, I don't think it's anything really like they're just stealing money, because their Kickstarter actually had to get canceled. It was supposed to come out really soon, I believe just like early October or something like that, probably a week away, and so they pretty much canceled the Kickstarter. So I'll leave the video that Paul Phoenix actually made himself. He actually did a live stream about 20 minutes long explaining why the Kickstarter was canceled. And first of all, I just wanted to say that my condolences and everything go out to Paul Phoenix, because he's been going through a lot, and I mean, I can't imagine how difficult it is to make a project by yourself. Well, he's not necessarily by himself, but he's doing a lot of work. He's putting in his own money into the game, and that's why he needed the Kickstarter, was, you know, to get it started. And people were really hard on this project, and the reason was because, you know, there wasn't enough footage. And Paul explained that the reason there wasn't enough footage is because he didn't really have the money which he was trying to get from Kickstarter. Another reason was that people were, I guess, bored or a little skeptical of the horror asymmetrical genre after Friday the 13th, which is completely valid. But at the same time, I think we need to give another game a shot. If we just, you know, dwell on the past of Friday the 13th and how it died, those circumstances are so rare that that's definitely not going to happen with this game. So I mean, this is incredibly sad to see. I do not know the full story, I guess only Paul really does, but it's incredibly heartbreaking to see something like this happen, and to see, you know, people get to Paul in the way they did, to actually force him to take down the Kickstarter just so he could save his own mental health, which I respect completely. You need to look after yourself first. The community comes second. So I mean, what do you guys think down below in the comments? Did you guys even know about this killer game? Were you guys excited for the Kickstarter? Were you gonna back it? I hope I could, you know, shed some light on the whole situation, explain some things. Please do go support Paul Phoenix. I'll leave his channel as well as the live stream down in the description. Thank you all so much for watching, and yeah, goodbye.